So its mitochondrial outer membrane, its inner membrane, and its intramembrane space. On inner mitochondrial membrane located electron transport chains that is composed of 4 protein complexes and coenzyme Q. And also there is 5th complex called ATP synthase that has its own unique function. Before explanation, I have to mention that complete mechanism of thermogenesis is unknown, so here it will be the most easy to remember explanation how heat is generated. The general concept here is that protein complexes in electron transport chain use energy that is contained in electron to drive hydrogen protons from mitochondrial matrix to intramembrane space. And by this electron transportation from one complex to another, complexes generate energy. 50% of this energy used to drive hydrogen protons from mitochondrial matrix into the intramembrane space, and 50% of energy generated as heat to maintain our body temperature. This hydrogen movement occurs at the level of complexes 1, 3, and 4. The major idea of this hydrogen transport is to lower proton concentration in mitochondrial matrix and to increase hydrogen proton concentration in intramembrane space. This process results in creation of hydrogen proton concentration gradient through inner mitochondrial membrane with high hydrogen proton concentration in intramembrane space and lower concentration in a mitochondrial matrix. And ATP synthase uses this concentration gradient, and by transportation of hydrogen protons by concentration gradient into the mitochondrial matrix, it generates energy. And ATP synthase uses this energy for phosphorylation of ADP that results in production of ATP molecules. So, if all energies that electron transport chain generate is 100%, 50% of this energy dissipates as heat, and another 50% is conserved in ATP molecules. We see that the major goal here is to create hydrogen proton concentration gradient. First of all, it's possible only because in normal condition mitochondrial inner membrane is impermeable, especially for hydrogen protons. So the only possibility for hydrogen protons to cross mitochondrial membrane is to cross through protein complexes. Because protein complexes transport hydrogen protons from mitochondrial matrix where protons concentration is much lower to intramembrane space where hydrogen protons concentration is much higher, and any transportation that occurs against concentration gradient requires energy, so to keep oxidative phosphorylation going, protein complexes permanently require energy. And the only source of energy for them is energy that is contained in electrons. Basically, protein complexes 1, 3, and 4, they are like dementors from Harry Potter. They are absolutely greedy for energy, and the source of energy for them are electrons. They suck energy out of electrons, and as any voracious predators, they eat massively 50% of electrons' energy they consume, and simultaneously 50% dissipates in the process of energy consumption. And this 50% of energy that dissipates is actually heat that forms our body temperature. So electron complexes suck the energy out of electrons one after another until electrons will be completely energy depleted. And after complex 4 sucks the last portion of energy out of electron, now electron has no energy inside. Such electron is a wasted material that does not have any value for electron transport chain. So complex 4 throw out this low energy electron from electron transport chain to oxygen inside the mitochondrial matrix, and electrons bind to oxygen and reduce oxygen with formation of water molecules. So as we see, electrons have definitely hard times here. Basically, electron transport chain is a slaughterhouse for electrons. But electron transport chain is not perfect, and some electrons can leak out of electron transport chain, and in this situation they reduce oxygen in another fashion. They reduce oxygen with formation of superoxide, which is reactive oxygen species, so it's a very dangerous molecule. So some very tricky electrons can find the way out of it, and as a result they become very dangerous substances for mitochondria in the cell. But how electrons are delivered to electron transport chain? For this purpose we have mobile electron transporters as NADH and FADH. Recall that, for example, in Krebs cycle, acetyl-CoA is systematically degraded by the enzymes, and some enzymes in Krebs cycles that are called dehydrogenases have NAD and FAD molecules as cofactors. So while enzymes degrade acetyl-CoA, NAD and FAD molecules takes out electrons from acetyl-CoA. Each of them can pick up 2 electrons, and important that it's high energy electrons that are completely filled with energy. And when they picked up electrons, they transport them to electron transport chain, and each of the transporter has its own site of delivery. NADH is by far the major electron carrier. It's the most popular coenzyme for dehydrogenases, and NADH delivers electrons to the complex 1. FADH is less popular, but some enzymes use it. For example, succinate dehydrogenase in Krebs cycle, or fat-acyl-CoA dehydrogenase in beta oxidation, or glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase in glycerol phosphate shuttle. So, in case of FADH, complex 1 does not get any energy from electron, thereby it remains inactivated and do not pump any hydrogen protons, thereby hydrogen proton concentration gradient will be lower, and the lower is hydrogen proton concentration gradient, the lower amount of ATP produced. So NADH activates all three complexes, and this results in production of 2.5 ATP molecules. FADH activates only two complexes, and this results in production of 1.5 ATP molecules. So how these protein complexes work? Protein complex is basically an assembly of different proteins, and the major concept is that some of these proteins for their function use metal ions. The most important example is complex 4. In complex 4, one of the proteins use ferric iron, which is iron in plus 3 state. When complex 3 transport electron to complex 4, iron receive electron, and with one additional electron, iron now is converted to plus 2 charge. Then complex 4 sucks the last portion of energy out of electron, uses energy to pump hydrogen protons into intermembrane space, and throw out this low energy electron from electron transport chain to oxygen inside the mitochondrial matrix, with subsequent water production. And now, without electron, iron again become plus 3 charge. This process is repeated cyclically, time after time, electron after electron. So, as a summary, in enzymatic dehydrogenase reactions, mobile carriers take out high-energy electrons and deliver them to electron transport chain, where some complexes take the energy from electron. In this process, 50% of energy dissipates as heat, and another 50% protein complexes used to pump hydrogen ions into the intermembrane space. This electron flow results in creation of hydrogen proton concentration gradient that is used by ATP synthase for phosphorylation of ADP to ATP. So, as we see, electron transportation that generates heat occurs simultaneously with creation of hydrogen proton concentration gradient that is used for ADP phosphorylation that results in ATP production. So these two processes occur simultaneously, and they are coupled to each other, and together it's called oxidative phosphorylation.